In this in particular, we are going to talk about the computational profiling analysis for climate and weather models. I am Mario Acosta from Barcelona Supercomputing Center. Obviously, we are working on these kind of things. And also in the second, I'm going to do a theoretical part. And Miguel Castillo, also from BSC, from our team. We'll talk about more a practical part, so you can know more about the tools that we usually use for this profiling analysis. So at the beginning, well, actually you can see here. Oh, sorry. So I can understand that you can see my second slide, isn't it?
Yes, yeah, we can see.
Perfect. So the main goals of this theoretical part is going to be define the performance analysis fundamentals. So you can start more about which is that the idea behind this computational performance analysis. Define a methodology to study these high performance computing numerical models in weather and climate. And also describe the BSC performance analysis tools. This is STRIPE, Parameter DBMS. It's true that there are other tools, so the course is going to be useful for you to understand more about the profiling analysis. And later, if you don't want or you prefer to use other tools, it's going to be the same for you. No, there are, I don't know, Vampire, Intel, Vitum. But there are other possibilities that you can choose in this case, okay? But we are going to do a brief course in the second part about the particular tools that we are using for our models. Also, we are going to interpret some use cases from Earth system models. So I'm going to give some details about our analysis with some of the models in which we are working. Apply profiling technique to identify the different performance bottlenecks in your code, so this is more practical. Finally, summarize some typical performance problems. So I'm going to give you some examples that we were working in the past. Finally, discuss some specific knowledge about the performance analysis applied to this Earth system modeling, no? So the specific cases related with this. Also to say that, well, if you have any question, it's 1 hour and 30 minutes, so it's very, very long. You can wait for the end, but also if you want to stop me, ask me something, there is no problem, okay? So if you have some question about a specific slide, please stop me, and we can discuss something in particular, some details, some doubts, whatever. Okay, so the main question at the beginning, no? Why this profiling analysis? Why did we need this idea about the computational part of the model and try to improve it, try to improve the performance, no? Well, the idea is that inside this numerical model, we have very big goals, no? For example, this projection where you have to simulate more than 100 years of the simulation. We have to do impact analysis. We have to think about the adaptation to the climate change. So we are talking about very big simulation where currently only this computational model have the potential to provide this specific estimation. Well, actually, this model are working okay. As you can see, for example, in the first one, in the ECNWF prediction in weather, along these years, the accuracy of this model has improved a lot. Okay, so the percentage is increasing a lot, and we are achieving a much, much better accuracy in the model that we are working. The question, why? Well, obviously there are several as well, but some of them are related with the complexity that we are increasing, we are achieving with the model. So we are including more and more components, more and more details in this model. So we are improving the model with the data observation. We are using now coupling component, for example, including the ocean with the atmosphere. And also, we are increasing the model resolution. So to improve the accuracy of this model, we have to increase the resolution of the grid that we are using. Well, the point here is that if we are increasing the complexity and the resolution, obviously, we are also we are going to need more and more computational power to try to simulate this new numerical model in the same way or in the same time that we did in the past. And you say at the beginning, taking into account the supercomputer, no, that we are developing, and also this path to SSK. Seeing this specific figure, it seems that there's no problem, no, because the supercomputing always is increasing the computational power that they are going to have. So the new supercomputer in 5 years is going to have a specific computational power which is going to increase linearly comparing to 10 years ago, no, something like that. But as you also know, the clock frequency of your processor stop in some moment more than 10 years ago. So actually this new computational power is not coming from a processor which is faster, okay? So in this case, obviously it's coming from another place, and obviously this is parallelization. So our supercomputers are much, much better in terms of computational power because they are increasing the hardware, and inside this specific hardware, because we can talk also about the memory, the interconnection, these kind of things, but of course it's increasing a lot because we are introducing more and more parallel resources, okay? And which is the problem here? Well, or problem or the issue. To exploit this computational power in the modern supercomputer and now in the SSK supercomputer which are coming, we have to exploit for sure the parallelism. And this parallelism is going to produce a lot of overhead. This is extra computation and communication. It doesn't matter the specific paradigm that you are going to use. And okay, maybe in some moment you say, okay, this overhead is seen that it's not a problem in my model, no? In some moment, I run my model and everything is more or less okay. But in the moment that you increase the complexity or this resolution, for example, maybe in some moment, if you have not done a computational profiling analysis, a bad implementation or even something that is seen is not bad in some moment, is going to be a problem in some point, okay? So this is the reason why we need to do this evaluation of the parallel efficiency when the hardware change, when the number of resources change, the model complexity change. Well, this is more or less the idea. And to do this performance profiling analysis, this computational analysis, we have to take into account several metrics. In summary, there are like the more important, no? The computation efficiency, which is related, for example, with the intrusion per second scaling, the how it's working with the specific cache memory access that you have for your model, if the NUMA access is okay, these kind of things, no? And also we have the parallel efficiency that I was talking before, no? The load balance of your total parallel resources, the communication efficiency, no? So are there some serialization in your model? Is the transfer or the communication that you are doing in some moment, the interconnection is good enough to do this communication, this kind of things? And of course, this is something that we are not alone, no? We are working in this profiling analysis, but actually this refactoring of the numerical code is taking a lot of attention in European project as EasyWays, but there are other projects in which we are working with our institution in this evaluation of the high performance computing models. Well, it's something that obviously is very important for the future of our models.
Excuse me.
Yeah, sure. Tell me.
Just a small question. You mentioned a lot of efficiencies in your previous slides. Are all of them can be evaluated somehow?
Yeah, exactly. So this is the idea. Obviously, the, maybe you can say that there are some tools which are better or easier to do the evaluation for some specific metric that maybe you can see here. But the idea is that with the BSC tools or other profiling tools, is that you can check and you can evaluate all of the metrics that, for example, you can see here. Okay, so obviously, for example, I don't know, the cache, no? The cache memory access. You have to collect some information from your execution. And in this case, for example, you will need a specific puppy counter, okay? In this case, you are going to have available in your hardware a specific library to do the discounting, no, of the this puppy counter related with the cache memory access. And then the profiling tool is going to collect this information from the puppy counter, and then you can do the evaluation, okay? This is an example, but for MPI, for other puppy content that you maybe need, for everything, you have some metric in the profiling tool that you will use for to do the evaluation, okay?
Great, thanks.
Okay, so yeah, and this is only a summary who we are, no? So actually, we are working on this. We are this computational earth science performance team in the middle, no? And we try to be like between this weather and climate science, so the scientific we are working with the model, and computer science, no? So the typical computer scientist or engineer which are working to try to improve, no? Or try to run your model, these kind of things. So we try to have the knowledge, the mathematical and computational knowledge of the Earth system application, the high performance computing part two, and try to apply this knowledge to improve the computational side of the model with the evaluation. This is an example, no, about the methodology that maybe we could use to try to improve the model execution of your model, no, for example. So at the beginning, we try to do this mathematical and computational study. So the question here, no, which specific method from the mathematical side is using your model? In this case, for example, which is this discretization? You know, no? Because you have, for example, the Navier-Stokes equation, and you have to discretize, taking into account the space and the time, to try to obtain something that you can run in an iterative mode, and you can simulate whatever that you want to simulate, okay? In this case, for example, we are talking about a fluid, so it's computational fluid dynamics, and ocean, atmosphere, whatever. Also, for example, which is the parallel adaptation? So we have solver, we have preconditioner, is everything is explicit, which is the way to do the parallelization, this kind of things, okay? And also, if maybe this is the method that you are using, maybe we can implement a new algorithm for a new architecture. And here, for example, is the typical example is the GPUs. This means, we are using this specific algorithm for the CPU. We are going to do the porting to the GPU, or actually there is something better that we can use for the GPU, this kind of question, okay? From the computational study, this is the typical, no? You have to do the analysis at the beginning and say, okay, there is a good load balance in the parallel resources that we are using, or actually some of the processes are working faster and we have to do something. There is some overhead in the parallel application itself, for example, in the MPI, too much communication, these kind of things. And also ensure that the computational algorithm takes advantage of the specific architecture that you are using. Because, you know, you are going to move a new supercomputer. I don't know. Maybe in this case, this is an example, no? Because obviously it's always your new supercomputer is going to be better, no? But imagine that you are using a supercomputer for other institution and the interconnection is worse, no? And you say, okay, now my model is working, the time that I achieving is worse, which is the problem. So we can try to understand that maybe the interconnection is worse in this case and try to suggest you that maybe you have to improve the interconnection, or at least you know the answer, okay?
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Sorry to...
No, it's fine.
Yeah, maybe to clarify some concept, scalability study. We could improve the performance, or
yeah. Well, in this case, So you have to take into account that this is a methodology to try to study the model itself. So the scalability study itself is not going to improve the computational side of your model. But in this case, we are doing a study. And you can see here at the beginning that we are studying the model itself with the mathematical study, for example. Then we are going to do a scalability study, which is this one, no? So the idea is try to launch your model using a different combination of parallel resources and try to understand the behavior of your model. And then we are going to do the performance analysis that I will talk now. And finally, in the fourth step, we are going to do some optimization. But for the optimization, we have to do the third step before to try to understand the model and try to understand the behavior. Okay?
Okay. Thanks.
So the scalability study itself is only to try to push your model and try to see what happens when we are using a specific parallel resources that maybe is not good enough for your model. So this means, for example, no, that maybe in the past you were using, for this example, you were using 1,000 processes and you say, okay, my model is working super fine, is linear, because the orange red color, the blue color is is achieving a linear scalability, okay? So if we are using 1,000 processes, actually, you can see that the performance is perfect, no? It's ideal. But, however, in the moment that you are using, for example, 3,000 processes, this performance is not going to be linear, okay? So in some moment here is the perfect moment to try to see what happened with your model and try to evaluate if you have some bottlenecks, if you have some problems or inefficiency in your specific model, okay? So this is the idea behind try to do some scalability models, okay? Studies, sorry. And actually, with the next one is coming the performance analysis. So we have the results of the scalability study. We are going to do some collection in this scalability study using the profiling tools, okay? So maybe we decide to use the 3,000 processes execution, and in this specific case, we are going to apply the profiling tools, okay? Actually, in our case, for example, we try to do the profiling analysis with different number of parallel resources, okay? Because in this case, the information that we are going to obtain is going to be more detailed. In our case, as I said before, we are using the BSC tool, but actually in this specific case, you can use other tools. This is up to you. And now we have some information, so we have to do the important part, no, the useful part for the scientific using the model is the optimization. So in this case, there are the different options. The first one and the typical one is try to improve slightly the algorithm that you are using for your numerical methods and try to, apply some specific method which are found in the literature, or try to improve the method with a new approach, okay? But with a new approach is using yet the same numerical model, the same discretization that you are using, this kind of thing. The second option is try to say, okay, we are going to introduce a new algorithm and try to, try to apply a new research that maybe is going to be better for your new architecture, for your new model, whatever. So, for example, here, a good example are the DSLs. So, I don't know if you did this course yet, but this about the DSL is a revolution in your model in the future, okay? Thinking about the future of the numerical methods. And this is outside of the scope of the course, but only to take into account that if we are going to introduce optimization, of course, we have to ensure that the results, the scientific results of your model are going to be pretty similar, okay? So in our case, we have a reproducibility study, we have a publication about this, where we are following a specific method, and you can see here that if, for example, the green color was the simulation before the optimization, and the orange color is after the optimization. And as you can see, we are try to ensure that the result that you are obtaining is inside a particular spread, and the result that you are obtaining are pretty similar to the result that you were obtaining before the optimization, okay? So I'm not going to enter in detail about this, but at least you have to know that when we introduce computational optimization, we have to ensure that the results are pretty similar, okay? And yeah, and this is part of the reproducibility. So moving to the main part of this this course, no, the BSC tools. We are going to introduce the main ones, which are extrae to do the collection, Parabel to do the evaluation with a graphical interface, and also we can do some simulation with DMMS. I will talk later about this. And also how to work with large traces, because extrae is going to collect a lot information, but a lot of information, everything about your execution. So maybe you have to know something about how to manage these traces and try to do the to take only the important part of the collection and try to do the analysis. So the BSC tools, we are working with these tools from several years now. And the idea is that you are going to use the extrae library at the same time that your application. Okay, so for example, you are using MPI RUN for the MPI application, and you are going to introduce the extrae library at the same time that the MPI RUN. Okay, this is going to produce some traces. These traces later you can use Parabel to do this this graphical view and try to do the evaluation. Okay, and also for example, we can use DMMS to try to do this this simulation that I will talk later, no, because probably it's going to be easier to understand. These BSC tools are free tools, so you can access in this web page at the end below. And you can download the tools, and also you have different tutorial, different introduction to try to to understand more about the specific tools. And well, if you have apart from the practical course that is going to do Miguel, if you want to know more, as I said, you can download the tools and also download different tutorial slides to understand better about these specific tools. You have also some basic example here, so you don't need to go to your application directly. Maybe you want at the beginning to use the tutorial with a small example to understand better the tools, okay? As I said before, the first part is run with your application, use extrae library and collect the information, okay? This is going to produce the traces, this .prv, this .psf, okay, these kind of things, and produce these traces that then you can use other tools, as for example Parabel, to do the analysis. To do this, so we are now entering detail, no? I'm going to tell you something about how to set up these profiling tools, but well, if you have some doubt, you can go to the tutorial, there's no need to enter in detail, okay? So something very important to tell you is that it's very easy and you don't need to do several changes in your machine to use the BSC tools. The idea is install extrae. This is something that is true that you have to do. Install extrae, install this library, but it's the only thing that you have to install, okay? Then you have to do this module load extrae before the you are going to run the application, and then you have to introduce this script, this for example for Fortran or C, this script at the same time that your application, and this script is going to look for the setup of the extrae for a XML. So you can put this XML in the same place, for example, that your application, and it's going to take from here all the parameters needed for the setup, okay? I will talk later more about this XML. And finally, this run parallel is an example. So you are using your specific script to run your model, and here is where you have to introduce the module log extrae and include at the same time that the run application, this trace Fortran, this trace C, okay? So this is the basic idea. And only with this, you are going to use Extrae and you are going to collect the traces for the profiling analysis, okay? This is for some, this is an example, no, about the trace for transcript. For example, here we are using variable environment, okay? And this variable is going to say, okay, if we are going to use Extrae, we are going to use, for example, OpenMP, okay? And we are going to activate the second one, no? This MPI plus OpenMP XML. If not, we are going to use the Extrae config by default, which is this one, no? This is only an example. And this is the XML. So here you can set up different parameters, but actually, if you are using the default XML, it's going to be fine, okay? Here you can, for example, activate the MPI tracing. You can activate or deactivate also the OpenMP tracing. You can, for example, add instrumentation to for some specific using functions. So imagine that you know, okay, I'm totally sure that this specific solver, and I know obviously which is the name of the subroutine, is the problem in my model. So you can, here in the user function, the fourth one, you can say, okay, we are going to introduce the instrumentation of Extrae for this specific solver, for this specific subroutine. And this is something that you can do directly. And the fifth one is also very important, is the puppy counter that you are going to use. The typical one at the beginning are the instruction, the cycle, the catch misses, the total, the resource style, the vectorization with the floating point operation, this kind of scene, okay? Here is where you have to introduce this puppy counter. And there's different ways, for example, you can ask to the operational people in your machine, but there are different ways to know which specific puppy counter you have available in your machine. But usually the default one are going to be there, okay? So the default one that you are going to find in this XML at the beginning, almost for sure are going to be available in your machine. And yeah, this is the second part of the XML, okay? So the other one was the first one, and this is the second part. Also, for example, we can say if we want to summarize some MPI events, so we are going to reduce the try size. Or for example, at the beginning, this is important, no? If you are running in 500, for example, MPI processes, obviously the collection at the beginning is done in 500 files. So at the end of the collection, you have to do some merging. This merging can be done individually at the end, or you can do automatically at the end of the execution, okay? So at the end, Extrae is going to say, okay, we have 500 files, and we are going to do the merging to collect one specific trace that then you can use with Parabel, okay? And this is another example in your script about how to use Extrae. So Extrae introduce some instrumentation to profile your model. So usually you don't want to use it. You want to use it when you want to do a profiling analysis, okay? But using, for example, this very stupid environment variable, you can say, okay, only when this is activated, we are going to use the load module Extrae, we are going to introduce the XML and the script, and we are going to run Extrae. In other cases, it's not needed. And at the end, if we are going to produce these trace files, we are going to copy to whatever place when you want to do the copy file. Okay, so this is the example about how to use the Extrae in a very stupid case. Okay, so now we have done the collection, and we have these traces, and we have to do something with it. No, this is the raw data. So obviously also this number that you can obtain in the collection are very difficult to understand in a non-graphical way. So Parabel is going to try to help you with this evaluation of your model. So para ver at the end is a trace visualization analysis tool, okay? But also it's going to be useful for the manipulation of the tool. And I will talk later about this. So this means that we can create new metrics, we can derivate, no, new metrics to do the analysis and try to do a much, much better and useful study of your model, okay? So how work this Parabel tool? The Parabel traces at the end is going to save different records, okay? So the most important is we are going to save state records. So this is, for example, the interval of a thread or status, no, a thread. In this case, we are talking about OpenMP, or, well, actually also MPI. For example, this state record can be also waiting in a barrier, no? So we have a synchronization barrier, and in this case, we are waiting for this. Also, it's going to save information about the event record. So this is punctual, so a moment in change something, okay? So for example, we are entering in a specific using function or we are exiting about one specific function. So in this case, it's an event that we are going to record and say, okay, this is the moment when we are changing from this specific subroutine to another one. Or for example, we are entering in an open MP parallel region, or we are finishing this parallel region, these kind of things, okay? And finally, also, we are going to save information about the communication record. In this case, we are going to have an MPI communication. This means that we are going to send some information, some data, from one parallel process to another parallel process. So with Extrae, Parabel is able to tell you, okay, the MPI communication is done from the process, for example, process 3 to the process 5, okay? And we are going to save this information and the size of the communication and, well, everything needed to do the evaluation later, okay? And, okay, this is your first trace, no? And this is how look a basic overview of a specific trace. In this case, and in all cases, in the y-axis, you can see the total parallel resources that you are using. This can be, for example, MPI processes, CUDA processes, or CUDA threads, sorry, OpenMP threads. The idea is that in this specific axis here, no, you have the parallel resources. And here in the x-axis, you have the time, no? So you have done the study for your profiling, for a specific execution of your model. So you are doing the study, the profiling for all this complete execution time of your model, okay? What can we see here? In this particular case, we are seeing the MPI events, okay? So the black color is outside MPI, so we are doing computation, okay? And with the other color, we are seeing different MPI events. For example, in this yellow golden color, there are all to all, and so we are talking about collective communication, okay? Actually, you can see that the collective communication, this golden yellow color, are taking a representative time of the execution of this particular timeline. Okay, this is the idea behind whatever trace that we are going to see now in the next slide and in the practical part, okay? How work Parabel? Well, from this timeline that I have explained you here, we can also obtain the CAL profiler. So the CAL profiler is basically the numbers, no, the percentage, for example, of the MPI event. So for example, with the CAL profile, we can see in this specific timeline, the collective communication represent a 20%. So this is the idea behind this CAL profile. And also we can talk about the useful duration. In this case, it's another metric that you can evaluate with Parabel. And from the useful duration, which is going to tell you, for example, no, here in the black color, the best useful is going to be here, no, because the useful is going to tell you how much time is working without any interruption. The interruption in this case is this overhead that is introduced for the parallel execution. In our case, we are always interested in do computation. If we have to introduce communication, this green color, red color, golden color, it doesn't matter. We are introducing something that is not, or imagine, no, is not going to be in the sequential, in the serial execution. So it's something that actually is interrupting your model. So it's not useful. And this is the idea behind this useful duration. From the useful duration, for example, we can also study the histogram. The histogram is only to try to represent the numbers, okay, of the different useful. And for example, the histogram, I will explain later this, no, is going to be useful to try to study the load balance of your model. I will talk later about the how you can use the histogram for to try to do this. At the end is, for example, this control window about the call profile that I will talk later, no, is going to tell you some value or color, which is a statistic, no, computed for this specific thread. So we are talking about, for example, no, the all reduce, and we are going to evaluate the all reduce for this one, no, the fourth thread, which is 104%, no, more or less. So this is the idea, no, about this MPI call. But we are talking about percent of the time, but actually we can also study different relevant statistics. For example, the percentage or the number of times that you are going to do the collection. For example, the all reduce, we know that that is very bad for the computer execution. So how many times we are doing this all reduce? And this is going to tell you, for example, that along the execution you are doing 10 all reduce, okay, for this specific thread or per thread, these kind of things. And talking again about this timeline that I was talking before, we can quantify the MPI function in different ways. In this case, for example, I was talking before about the all-to-all or the weight any. In this case, represent a significant amount of time, which is actually between these 15 and 10% respectively, okay? So it's a lot of time, because imagine that all this all to all, this with any, actually is an overhead that you are introducing with MPI, okay? Yet the execution of this specific timeline, this trace, is not bad, because in average, you can see in the outside MPI, in average, 70% of the execution is doing something useful, is doing the computation, the black color, no? So in this case, is okay. But this all-to-all is something to take into account, and maybe you want to introduce some optimization, or imagine, no? You want to improve your hardware, improving the transfer, because the all-to-all at the end is doing a lot of communication. Improving the all-to-all, improving the transfer efficiency of your hardware is going to improve the final execution time of your model, the performance of your model, okay? So only checking this specific table, you can start to imagine some optimization that you can do for your model. More ideas, no? More things that you can obtain from the parallel collection. This is, for example, the point-to-point connectivity matrix. This is, for example, important to try to understand how is working the communication in your model. So this is the point-to-point view from this timeline, okay? So these 576 processes are communicating in this way. And you can see most of the processes in the diagonal are communicating with some neighbor, okay? So this is why you can see this diagonal. Blue color is more communication, green color is some communication there, but less than in the blue color, okay? So most of the processes are communicating with, for example, no, north and south, east and west in the Arakawa C grid, but in other cases, no, you can see here at the beginning, okay, and here to the left. This represents that we have some master processes, okay, which are doing some communication with everyone. And this kind of communication is called master and slave, and usually represent much more time is a main bottleneck in the communication that you are doing. Some cases is needed, okay? So it's not matter to try to say, okay, if we are using a master-slave communication with the collective, for example, something wrong is happening. But the idea is try to say, okay, checking this point-to-point connectivity, I know that there are some master-slave communication, and maybe I can check what is happening and try to improve it, okay? So this is more or less the idea behind to try to check this kind of views. For example, also going to this collective communication, we cannot, okay, we saw what we said before, that is 15%, no? Now, we saw it in the first timeline, this one, the call. But actually, for example, we can do the study in using different ways to do the view with parallel. For example, we can study the enumeration and try to say that actually there are five collective communication, and we can separate this communication, okay? And for example, we can do the study independently. We can also study the size of the communication, the duration of the communication. Here is very important, because in the duration, you can see in this in particular, no, the color is changing, and this means that the duration is different, and here there are some load imbalance, okay? So this, for example, is important to try to see, okay, we have a load imbalance in the model, something that we can study later. And also, finally, also we can evaluate the bandwidth, okay, of your connected communication. Okay, so return to the histogram, no? The histogram is going to tell you, so again, no? To emphasize this, we are starting always from this timeline, okay? This, for example, about the call. From the call, we can create these tables that we saw before. This, for example, no, we can create these tables, and now we are going to create the histogram, okay? So we are yet doing the study from this one, no? So we are doing the study for a specific trace view, but we can collect more information from the histogram and using some specific metrics. In this case, for example, the metrics could be the bandwidth, could be the IPC, could be the duration, okay? And here, again, we have the processes, no? The MPI processes, the OpenMP processes, threads, sorry, whatever. And again, we can study different statistics, no? For example, the time, we are going to see later that is going to be useful, for example, to do this load balance study. And finally, also with Parabel, we can do more complex, we can create more complex metrics. What means this? Well, actually, if we have from the extra collection, we have the interval between the MPI events, and we also know the moment, the specific moment when the MPI call is done, we can create this derived window with the MPI call duration. Okay, so we are not creating nothing itself, but we can use different operation, okay, which can be arithmetical or logical operation to create more windows, no, more views, and to try to do more complex studies. One very simple that I say before, no, is this instruction per cycle. And probably this is something, no, if you have done some studies in computation, computational point evaluation, probably you know about the IPC, no, or at least about the SQL per instruction, no? Obviously, you are going to collect the instruction part and you are going to collect the cycle part. So doing a very, very simple operation here, we can create this instruction per cycle, okay? So this is more or less the idea. And finally also, that I was talking before about try to do the filtering and the cutting of the traces, okay? So something that probably if you are going to use BSC tools of other tools which are pretty similar, is that when you are doing the collection from extrae, the original trace is going to contain all the events from the execution. And this is going to be to have a size that maybe you don't want to use for the parallel study, okay? So actually this is 2 gigas, but maybe we are talking about a trace of 500 gigas, okay? So it's too much. So the idea is try to use the filtering bars mode to try to say, okay, so if for example we are going to study a numerical model, which is iterative process, no? We are going to simulate 500 time steps. And these 500 time steps actually are going to be pretty similar. So the idea maybe is try to use the filtering mode to try to say, okay, collect me only the MPI events. Okay, in this case, the user function is not useful for me. Collect only the MPI events, and this is going to reduce the size, okay, of this trace. But yet, you can see that with the filtering mode, if you are collecting only the MPI events, the time that you have run is exactly the same, no? Is this almost 600 seconds. But maybe you say, okay, I need more than the MPI event. In this case, I need all the events, but maybe only for one specific time step. So from the filtering mode, which is going to be very light, maybe you can say, you can open a parallel view and say, okay, and now I'm going to cut this specific time step, okay? And in this time step, I'm going to recover the complete event from the original trace, okay? So this is more the idea behind this filtering and cutting. Anyway, if doesn't matter if try, so you don't, it's not needed to try to understand just right now this methodology, because this is something that is included in the tutorial of the Parabel presentation that you can find in this webpage that I tell you at the beginning. Okay, well, this is part, no, about the filtering. This is one way to do it actually with MPI events. For example, with the cutting, no, this is the way that I was talking before, because if you are doing the cutting of the filter trace and then you substitute, you change the filter trace with the original trace, actually you are going to cut the original one. And this is the way to try to study the area of interest of, for example, one particular time step, but from the original one and not the filter one. Okay, but anyway, as I say, this is part of the tutorial presentation of Parabel, and there's no need to tell you more about this.
Just to clarify some basic things. When you mentioned about event, that means computation events and also MPI events, right?
Yeah. So the events, for example, in the computational side, is for example when you are entering in a specific subroutine. Okay, this is an event. In this moment, the extra is going to know that you are going from a level one subroutine to the level two subroutine, which is called from the level one. Okay, this is one specific event in the computational side. And the MPI events is very simple, no? For example, you are going to do a barrier, no? A MPI barrier. So this is a moment in you are calling to the MPI barrier and you are going to save the event in the moment that you are going to do this MPI barrier, this kind of things.
Okay, if one is interested in look at some computation part which cost a lot of time, is it also possible?
Sorry, can you repeat the question?
In case that one is would like to look into some computation part which takes quite some time, it's possible also to use this tool for
sure. Sure, actually, there is no problem. So, yes, actually, I think it's a good question, no? Because you say, okay, you are showing a lot of views with the MPI parts, no? But actually, I am interested in try to know and try to evaluate what happened in this black color, no? That I saw before, no? Is you say here, no? For example, there is a lot of black color. This is the computational part. I want to know more. I want to provide this part for sure. So, for example, with the useful duration of this is too soon per cycle that I showed you before, and I will show you later, it's possible to study this computational part with computational metric, which are going to study this part. No, so it's not only the MPI part. I started with this because it's easier, but actually we have several ways and methods to study the specific part with the computation. No problem. I will talk later more about this. Okay, so yeah. Okay, yes. This is actually talking about this, no? From Parabel, we can study, or we can do with some general views, no, about these timelines. Also, we can do the study with the context puppy and try to do some derivative metrics. Also, we can take some views for the MPI or OpenMP, or actually we have some for the complete profile, no? So there are some configuration that Miguel, we told you more about the configuration, which are prepared for you to do some specific studies of your model, okay? This configuration is going to take some information from Stray and try to show you in Parabel. This is the idea. I will talk about DMMAS later, but I want to, because we have 35 minutes, so I will try to enter into more about the profiling itself, okay? And this is the steps that we propose you to do the profiling study, okay? So the first thing, and important, of course, is say, okay, which is the area of study in my execution that I want to profile, okay? So usually, you don't want to profile everything, okay? So usually maybe you want to profile a one particular time step or one specific part of your model, one specific subroutine because you know that is the worst thing, these kind of things, okay? And well, at the beginning is this, no? I was talking, no? Which configuration I am using. For example, no, if the radiation takes too much time in this atmospherical model, is needed to include it or not, these kind of things, okay? And this is the thing that we are going to do, no? We are going to try to evaluate which is the time step, for example, the area of interest that we are going to profile. In this in particular, as you can see, no, this area of interest is going to include all the steps that you are going to do in your numerical model. And in this case, for example, we have this transformation and grid and spectral computation. So the area of interest is going to include these four steps. Once these four steps are included in the trace, we don't need or we can reject the other part of the execution. Also, well, this is the same, no? It's including everything. But also we have another way to do the study. In this case, this is from Nemo. We are going to do the simulation of one complete day, so we are including several time steps, but this color are representing user functions. So in this case, for example, we forget about the MPI events and we are taking into account the user function, the computational side of, well, actually everything, no, from your model. And here we are going to say, okay, which are the specific functions which are taking more time? Okay, this is that you can see here at the bottom. For example, we are going to say, okay, we are going to study not one complete time step, we are going to study only the five user functions which are taking more time, okay? And this is the way in which we are going to do the study here. So here we are going to simulate always one complete day of the NEMO, the OCEAN simulation, but then we are going to filter and cut only the five user functions which are taking more time. Okay, this is the idea. For the previous one, was not like that, no? For the previous one, we were taking one complete time step and we are going to study all the user function for this one complete time step. So it's only some example for you, no? About how to do this area of study. Yes, tell me.
But what is time step, please?
Oh, sorry, well, this is, sometimes, you know, you think that the people know about what you are doing. When you are working with, for example, this fluid dynamics, no, you are doing the discretization of the equation that you are using, and usually you have to do this discretization for the time. So this means that for a study, for example, in weather, no, you are going to do the evaluation of one complete day, so you are going to try to predict the weather in one day before, you have to discretize the time. This means that the time is not going to be continuous. If the time, you are going to do the study, for example, per, I don't know.
It's about one integration time step.
Exactly, yeah, so the time step is one integration time step, yeah.
It's all right. Thanks.
Yeah. Okay, this is for the area of interest, no? So now you know which is the area of study that you want to do. Now you have to think about the deployment efficiency, okay? Also, this is something that usually people don't think too much, but actually it's very important for you. Which compilation flags are going to use? Are you using floating point option, for example, this fast, precise, these kind of things, and something that is maybe sometimes seems very basic, but actually very important for you also. Which optimization option are you using? In Intel, for example, the typical is this O1, O2, O2, O3. Usually, you have to use something and that is, so you have to provide to your compiler the possibility to optimize the model that you are going to provide. This means that if you want to try to provide something which is working very bad, from the beginning, from the compiler option, you are going to optimize something that is not true, okay? So it's not the reality of your model. The reality is coming from try to leave or to your compiler to do the most optimization possible, okay? This, for example, this O3 in Intel, try to activate the vectorization, try to activate all the compilation flags that you know that probably is going to optimize your model. And after this, is the moment to try to do the profiling analysis of your model, okay? So this is the idea more or less about the try to set up this compilation flag. Also, it's very important to introduce the debug flags. This, for example, this minus G, no? Why? Because extrae is going to collect some information which is coming from the debug mode. So if you are not introduced this minus G, for example, it's impossible to try to collect information from the user function, these kind of things. Also, this is happening for other profiling tools, okay? So, for example, with Intel, you have to also activate the debug flags if you want to use the Intel tools to do the profiling, okay? Then you have the area of study and you have the setup, so you are compiling your model, no? Now we have to think about the benchmarking. So we have to think about which is the particular runs that we have to do the evaluation. And we return here to this scalability analysis that we were talking before, no? At the beginning, something very important is some basic test to try to understand your machine, okay? Why this? Because imagine that you are going to say, okay, this model with the MPI is working very bad, and this is horrible, and we have to improve the MPI part. Okay, probably this is going to be true, but it's also try to be important, for example, to study the latency of bandwidth, or for example, the interconnection of your specific machine. Why? Because maybe if you are using another supercomputer, instead of, I don't know, a small commodity cluster that you are using, maybe you are going to discover that this MPI part that you say in the profiling, okay, was horrible, maybe it's not as horrible as you were thinking, and maybe your problem is your platform. I know that in any case, no, you are discovering something that is useful, no, improving the communication, improving the MPI part. However, maybe you also are going to discover that default is not this effort to try to improve this part maybe is not good enough comparing to try to apply for a better supercomputer. Okay, this kind of things is the reasons why it's very important to do some basic tests at the beginning to try to understand your hardware. Once you understand your hardware, you can move to the real test that you are going to do for the profiling. And here we have this weak and strong scaling test. I'm not going to enter into here, but only too important to know that we are talking here, for example, about this scalability analysis, no? So try to evaluate different parallel processes for the MPI or for the OpenMP or hybrid, no? So actually we can combine this MPI plus OpenMP and try to see what happened, okay? So is scaling in a linear way, in an ideal way, until which moment, no? And in the moment in this linear scalability is stopping, what is happening here? If here is a perfect moment to introduce the profiling tools and see what happened, okay? And try to see which is the specific bottlenecks that is appearing in the moment that the scalability is non-linear. This is one example about how to use this benchmarking, okay? Also, we can compare in optimization. This, for example, double precision and single precision. So your benchmarking, for example, is, imagine, no? You are going to introduce optimization that you know that is going to work. Pues the only thing that we have to do is compare before and after the optimization and see what happened. This is another way to try to use your profiling tools. Also, for example, mathematical algorithms. So we are going to compare this specific solver and this specific solver. This solver is faster, but to do the convergation. But maybe is slower in the computational side. So maybe we can use the profiling tools to try to do the evaluation about which is the problem with the specific solver and try to see which is better at the end. Okay. This is what I was talking before. No, this is with a strong scaling test, changing the number of MPI processes. Okay. And this is a basic analysis. I think that Miguel will tell you about this in particular. So he will give you some practical sample. This is a summary that you can obtain with the BSC tools. Okay, this is not coming from Parallel, it's coming from another which is called Model Factor or Basic Analysis. But anyway, it's going to tell you some information, basic information that you can see in Parallel. Okay. For example, here we can see that the global efficiency is close to this 75%, and maybe the problem is coming from the communication efficiency, no? Because here we can see that the communication efficiency is drawn back, and maybe the worst part is coming from the transfer efficiency. So only with this single view, you can imagine, you can suppose more or less where is coming the main bottleneck of your execution, your application. And well, this is more or less the same about the basic tools. Now, we know which is the area of study. We know more or less which is the setup to compile your model. And we know which is the benchmarking that we are going to do. No? This, for example, set of different MPI number of processes. Now, we have to talk about the profiling analysis itself, okay? So I'm going to talk about this clustering sampling are complex tools, okay? And maybe actually it's better that I will get you more about the example, so I'm not going to enter in detail. I'm going to enter in detail more about the thirst first, okay? And maybe the MMS. So I was talking before, this is coming about the MPI profile, no? So from the MPI call view, we can obtain the MPI profile summary, and something that you can see, you should check at the beginning, is this parallel efficiency. And you have to ask, this parallel efficiency is less than 85%. So if it's less than 85%, probably there is some issue in the parallel execution that maybe you can check and try to improve, okay? For this, maybe you can evaluate the communication efficiency, okay, which is called this with the maximum, and the global load balance. And you can see there is 90% in this, 91% in this case. Mm-hmm. Also, yes.
And this table comes from the BST tool or from the model factor tool?
No, this is not coming from the model factor. This is coming directly from the model, from Parallel. You open the MPI call view, and then you can create this profile summary. Miguel will give you the example. So he will obtain this profile summary, and you will see how to obtain it with the Parallel buttons. Of course, in this theoretical part, I will go faster, but then with the practical part, you will see how to obtain some of these views that I'm going to show now. About the puppy content, well, this is, for example, the list that I introduced in my study in the XML, okay? So I introduced the instruction, the cycle paper, puppy content, and then this mark with the cross in the derivative is not collecting directly. They are created after the collection with, for example, this instruction per set called useful is taking the useful events and the instruction and the cycle to create this is useful instruction per second. Okay, so the idea is try to create different configuration that are going to be useful for the profiling. Something useful for you and something that probably you are going to be interested. This about this puppy counter, this list, some of them are configuration that they are safe for you. So they are available for you in the tool in Parabet, and you don't need to create these derived views. They are there as configuration, and directly you can open the configuration and it's going to show you directly this useful duration, the useful IPC. Okay, so you don't need to create it. You the only thing that you have to do is open a configuration with someone save for you in the past. Okay, and all of these that I am showing for you are created in the default configuration of the puppy content. Okay. This is an example. So we, I am showing you at the beginning, above, no, this MPI call of the area of interest. And for example, here we can see the L3 total catch misses. You can see, for example, in this specific moment that the total catch misses is higher. Okay, or for example, the useful IPC. So it's different ways to see the this view of the puppy content. Again, this is going to be more unstable with the Miguel lecture. More about the puppy counter, we have here more example. I'm not going to enter in details here more about this part. Okay, here is with another one with the OCEAN part. Okay, so for example, something that is easy to see here. The institution per cycle, usually you have to achieve the best possible, or the more high IPC you have, the better is going to run your model, okay? Because the institution per cycle is going to tell you how faster is working the computational side of your model, okay? So for example, here we have a high IPC, okay? And you can see that actually the catch misses in this specific part is very slow. So we can say that here we have a correlation where this IPC is faster because the way that is done the computation in this part is very good and there is no catch misses, at least in L1, but I know that in L2 and L3 is similar, and the this IPC is very good. Okay, for example, in another part, for example, here, no, is also including a black color, so we are talking about computation. This IPC is not too much. However, this catch misses is too much. Okay, so also we can see here that it's correlated, and actually this is a specific thing that maybe you can study, okay, in your model. So what happened here? Which the catch misses is too much here is something that maybe you can study, and with this maybe you can improve the IPC in this specific part. Okay, so again, this is only to make you an idea about how to use the puppy contest views, and not to study a specific model, something that Miguel will tell you later. Also, we can do a MPI evaluation. Okay, so in this specific part, we are talking about this very big MPI communication. This is, remember, no, all to all, a collective communication. And we can see here also the duration of this MPI communication and the size that we are communicating. Something that actually is very interesting is that this in particular communication is taking the longest duration, okay? However, the size is not the big one. For example, this communication is the size is bigger. However, the duration of this part is lower, okay? So something is happening with this specific MPI communication. I don't know if you can imagine, but the problem is the load imbalance, okay? And the problem is that the black color of these MPI processes is bigger in this specific part, okay? For example, in this one, no? And it's producing a load imbalance here, and it's producing that the MPI collective communication is going to start before technically should happen, for example, in this moment or in this moment, and is producing this longer time for a call duration, which actually is not too much in size, okay? So this is more or less about this load imbalance. I will tell you now about with the histogram about what is happening actually. And it's here, no? So the as I say before, I promised before, we can use the histogram from the IPC profile, something also Miguel will show you how to obtain this profile from the puppy contest views. We can obtain the profiles. So remember, here we have the threads or the NBA processes, and here we have the duration. Okay. So if with the profile, if we obtain something like that, like which is like a vertical line, this means that all the processes are taking more or less the same duration to do the same activity. Okay. And this means obviously that we have load balance. We have something which is taking more or less the same time to do the same thing. But however, here, so you can see here that this is not for sure a vertical line. So here in the different MPI processes are taking almost random times, okay, to do the same activity. With the profile also, we can see which specific part is doing this. And here we can see that actually, like a curve, no, we can see that there are some load imbalance in the execution of this computational part. And this is producing, this load imbalance is producing the problem in the MPI communication, which is before, okay? So everything is connected, and at the same time, you can try to optimize some specific part, for example, the load imbalance here, to try to improve different part of your model execution, okay? Well, as I see before, and for example, here we can see the connection between the different nodes or among the different nodes, okay? Something that may be useful to try to study the affinity of your model. And I say before, there are other tools, which is not Xtrae, is not Parabel, for example, the clustering, the tracking tool, but you know, we have 15 minutes more than I would like to show you some about example, instead of explain you more about the complex tool apart from Xtrae and Parabel, okay? So I will go to DMMAS directly. There is also the sampling, the folding, but well, there are more complex tools, okay? So DMMAS, this one I think is useful for you. DMMAS is very simple to use. It's coming from, so the idea is try to start, okay, from your execution. So this real run is the trace that you have obtained with your execution, okay? And this real run have gathered or reduced or to all, whatever, okay? And now DMMAS is going to apply to simulate the execution of your model in this what if, no? And the idea of what if, this is the idea, no? Imagine, for example, that you are going to use an ideal network. This means you are going to use a bandwidth, which is infinite, and a latency, which is zero, okay? This is, for now, it's impossible. It doesn't matter the machine that you are going to use in the future. But imagine that this is possible, no? So this is going to produce you a new trace which is applying this ideal network. And why this is useful? You can see here the idea. And here also, this is the specific trace that or model that we have studied in the theoretical part. Okay, and here, for example, we were talking about the load imbalance, no? So now we are going to apply this ideal network. And here you can see that most of the time related with MPI communication is almost zero, no? So disappear. Here also disappear a lot, okay? However, in this specific part where we know that there is some load imbalance, this communication actually is taking yet too much time. So even with an ideal network, so even changing the machine and using a machine which is technically better with the interconnection, this part is not going to improve. And this is very important as conclusion of your profiling analysis, because it's telling to you that actually, if you're not going to improve the load imbalance of this part in the computation, it doesn't matter if you improve the hardware, that this is not going to improve, okay? So this part is very, very important to try to see, okay, this is one of the main bottleneck that I have in my model, and I have to improve it, because if not, it doesn't matter if I improve the machine, this is going to be a problem in my model now and in the future, Okay, so this is something, this is a very interesting conclusion that you can obtain with MMRs. So we were talking about the ideal network, but as actually you can also do other simulation. For example, an ideal processor. Okay, so in this case, for example, imagine that we have a clock frequency infinite, and let's see what happens. Okay, so you can think, no, you can set up different parameters and use the MMRs for this. Okay. Nothing else. So about the validation, again, I'm not going to enter in detail because it's up to you the scope. Only to say again that if we introduce optimization, we have a validation test that we use to try to see this one, no? So in some specific cases, for example, this red color is telling to you that the optimization that we introduce in this case is only compiling with xhost, okay? So this is an optimization introduced by the compiler. And so here is happening something, because the result, this with the red color, is completely different to the result that we were obtaining in the past, okay? And now some example about what we did some optimization that we did to try to understand better. However, we have 10 minutes more and this then is the break. So maybe instead of go to the example that I will give you now, and maybe if you have some question that you leave at the end, maybe we can go for this. If not, I can spend the 10 minutes with example, as you prefer. So do you have some specific question about the theoretical part that you want to do, or I can proceed with examples? So please go ahead if you want to ask something. Well, I see now in the chat that something was asked, but actually Jack and Miguel as well, so thank you. Okay, so I will spend the last minute with example, okay? So one example about how to use these profiling tools. For example, here, this example was using a different number of MPI processes, okay? The number is not too much, but it's 16, 48, okay, and 288 processes. And you can see here that you were reducing the execution time of your benchmarking, okay? However, you can see that there is some specific user function with this color, no, this red, green, and yellow, blue, that they were not reducing too much. So only with this time of view, this timeline, you can check and you can see that actually there is some problem with this user function, okay? And if we go to detail, entering detail about what is happening here, you can see that the problem was some MPI communication, okay? As you can see, there are several MPI communication in sequential, okay? In this case, to do some border exchange, and this MPI communication, try to do the MPI send, wait for the receive, try to do the second MPI send, wait for the receive. This kind of things was something that in a scalability test was failing, okay? And in this case, we were obtaining a serialization of the execution, this one, and it's impossible to increase the efficiency of the parallelization using this kind of algorithm. The solution here, well, the idea was to improve this communication implementation and try to reduce the number of point-to-point messages. So try to package this communication all together, because as you know, there is no computation, there is no blue color here, so we can package the communication here, okay? Try to do only maybe one, two communication and try to reduce or even remove this serialization in this part, okay? And using this, I have not the solution. Well, so you have to believe me. Using this package and try to reduce also this number of collective, the execution time of this part was improved a lot, okay? And we can obtain some scalability also in this specific function. Another example. For example, here, no? This was interesting in the past because, for example, you can see here, no, this part which is called coupling, okay? Some institution or well, some people did some tests at the beginning using this number of processes, no? here at the bottom. Sorry, at the top. And in this specific part, they say, okay, the coupling was more or less, imagine, no, a 10% of the execution time of the model. And they say, okay, the coupling is not too much because it's more or less a 10%. However, the profiling tools sometimes is very useful because you can see that actually if we increase the number of MPI processes, okay, this 10%, which was at the beginning, was more than 50% in the moment that you increase the parallel resources of this IFS part, okay? So imagine, no, you are increasing the number of MPI processes, and now you say, okay, the final execution time of the second part is whatever, okay? If you are not doing this kind of profiling, it's difficult for you to see that actually the problem here is coming from the coupling, okay? So the main problem here is not the model itself, execution, is the coupling between the two models, okay? And this is coming again for a serialization because here in the coupling we have a lot of MPI communication with a master process, okay, the first one. So if you are doing this kind of serialization, obviously this is not going to scale. And the more processes you are using, the more problems you are going to have for to do the scalability of your model. Okay. Again, this was solved introducing a not master slave algorithm here. Actually, this is I have the results. So once we introduce this non master slave algorithm, you can see the huge difference between the coupling here and the coupling here. Okay, here we are using exactly the same number of processes, but we change the algorithm, and well, the now the difference is very, very big. This green color now is only waiting because we were using the same setup than in the past. Okay, so you can see here that NeMo, the second part, no, is taking this time. So if we improve now all this part of the coupling and the NeMo is taking this time. Since we are talking about coupling, so we have to exchange some fees between these two components. Now the IFS part has to wait to finish NeMo to finish this part. The solution here now, try to increase the number of processes for the NeMo part. And in this case, maybe we are going to improve this waiting, no? Because in this case, maybe IFS is not going to wait too much time. And this is not always happening because maybe you increase the number of MPI processes of NeMo and it's not going to increase the, reduce the execution time. So not always is like that, okay? Just tell me if you want.
This results come from the BST tools as well?
Yes, always. So all these views that you are seeing are coming from a model which is called ECL, okay? And which is using the IFS atmospherical model component and the NeMo ocean component. And all of these are collecting with Manustrum 3 and Manustrum 4 hardware, using Xtrail for the collection and Parabert for these views, these graphical views that you are checking here. Okay. I don't know. I have more example, but we are almost finishing. Maybe this could be the last one. This is not only using MPI, no? I was talking before. Here we have also, you can see here, no, that there is like a very small points, dots here in the blue part, no? In this computational part. Actually, this was a very small granularity of the OpenMP parallel regions, okay? So here, this algorithm tried to use parallel region for all the very small loops, the typical for loops, for example, and at the end was even worse than using the OpenMP part. Why? Because the OpenMP have to create the threads and destroy the threads, okay? And if we are here, for example, using 500, for example, no, OpenMP parallel regions, actually at the end is going to be worse. The solution, try to do the fusion of all these small granularity OpenMP parallel regions and try to create a very big parallel regions. And in this case, you can see that in the second part, this blue color actually technically the same, no, but I changed the colors. This blue color, you cannot you cannot see now this very small dot color here because now the granite is much better. And only changing this, we can see that we have reduced almost 20% of the final execution time, okay? Because now we have only one quartz OpenMP parallel region, okay? Well, I have more example, but technically is more or less the same. And now you have the break. Please try to think that actually I wanted to give you a general overview about why we have to use these profiling tools and some ideas about how to use the profiling tool. But to try to understand better in a practical way, X-Try and Parallel, now Miguel is going to give you with an example this idea about how to use it and maybe some ideas about, okay, and this is the specific views that maybe I want to use, and maybe this is the specific thing that I want to test with my specific model, okay? So try to don't be confused yet, because with the practical part, probably you are going to understand much, much better about the practical part of this X-Try and Parallel.
Can I ask, how about the technical support to other users in case of questions?
This is also a very good question. So these X-Try and Parallel tools are coming from the computational science department. As I say at the beginning, we are the earth science department. So about the support, there are a specific tools which is called the BSC tools team, which is there to support you, to support the user, okay? So you can, for example, download the tools and then ask by email to this team. So there is a specific email. And you can do, to install the X-Try tool, you have some problem, some error when you are doing the collection, all these kind of things are supported by these BSC tools, okay, team. And then if we are talking about the Earth system numerical models, numerical application, also in our case, no, in the Earth Science team, in the performance team, Earth Science department, sorry, computational group performance team, we have also some collaboration, for example, using PRAISE project or using European project. We can collaborate with other institutions and try to support you to use the profiling tools or to provide you the performance study of your specific model, no? So we have some ways to collaborate and try to provide this kind of support. But if you are talking about technical support, there is a specific thing in the computational science department which is going to help you for sure.
Thank you.
Okay, so if there is one more question, maybe we can finish here for the break, and in 30 minutes, Miguel will go for the practical part. Thank you, everyone, for listening to me, and see you now.